We heard about this wonderful city with a pretty laid-back atmosphere in the northern part of Thailand that was just what we were looking for after the craziness of Bangkok. Chiang Mai is the third largest city in Thailand. While walking through its streets, you can't help but notice the beautiful architecture of temples and really can feel the importance of tradition and religion. The slower pace of people is contagious and really makes you want to take it a little slower too. You can even buy rainwater from coin-operated dispensers on the street. Chiang Mai is a very green city with extraordinary plants, plenty of huge trees that provide people with shade on hot days and create a habitat for different types of birds. And if rabbits were allowed in the hostel, durians were not. This hostel's owner was such, I mean still is, such a lovely man that really helped us make the most out of the few days we had in Chiang Mai. Since the city is surrounded by mountains and beautiful nature, we decided to get ready, hopped in a tuk-tuk and spent a wonderful day with some explorers from all around the world. And some of them were here for a couple of days, others for a couple of months, and some were here with only one-way ticket. And I get why one would want to stay for a long time in this amazing country. Getting refreshed under a waterfall after a long hike in the mountains is a feeling I'd never experienced and won't ever forget. We found this elephant sanctuary about an hour away from the city that apparently treats the animals well. And I don't know what's going on when the tourists leave, but the people really seemed to care and the elephants seemed relaxed. Another destination on our list was the biggest Buddhist temple in Chiang Mai, Wat Phra Tat Doi Suthep. Top tier pronunciation, right? People call it Doi Suthep, but that's actually the name of the mountain on which the temple is built. Being in such a spiritual place, surrounded by people entering in communication with something bigger than themselves, is another scene I felt really thankful for witnessing and being able to capture. Because we are the one-in-a-kind tourists that also want to do the non-touristy stuff, we decided to go to another temple.
Surtout que j'ai plus de batterie, moi.
But this one was a little more hidden. Unfortunately, once we entered the jungle where the temple was hidden, we realized it was getting dark. So we decided to still keep walking and wasting the little battery we had left and kept recording. And then something that happens every night surprised us when it happened. It got dark. As you can see, the city was far away. There was no way we could walk back there. And the next expected thing happened. We got lost. In the dark. In a jungle. Actually, we didn't. But for the sake of the story and to add a little extra drama, let's say we did. At least, at this point we weren't, because 5 minutes later we got lost for real. And got bitten by plenty of things I prefer not to remember.
Café?
And that was the last time I saw Hugo.
Qu'est-ce qu'on fout là?
To be honest, I have no idea how we managed to end up in this person's tuk-tuk. But we were lucky we did find a car to take us somewhere close to the city. The next day, we decided to take it slow for a bit and entertained ourselves in areas where we did not have to be afraid when the night fell. We enjoyed plenty of cocktails and Belgian beer glasses, or at least tried to enjoy them. It's not that easy when you are with a mate like this one. It's such a weird thing to put the camera down and record yourself trying to act normal. But also, you want some memories of you in certain scenes with your friend. Another great thing to do, if you don't have agoraphobia, is to go to the very charming night markets in Chiang Mai. We became friends with this super cool expat English teacher. The night ended with a big fight though. I am not the biggest fan of martial arts, but seeing Muay Thai in Thailand is a thing to do when visiting. What I discovered was a fascinating sport. Actually, it's more than just a sport, with all the rituals around it, the hypnotizing Sarama music, and the whole thing, really. And you have to appreciate the athleticism and the dedication of the fighters. Long story short, don't leave Thailand without going to at least one Muay Thai event. You might discover a new passion for something you didn't expect. Keep this guy. He created his own tripod out of bamboo. Chiang Mai is a very entertaining city with lots of events. People would play live music in the streets, in bars, sometimes in nightclubs, where the DJ would stop his set and the live band would come on stage and play some tunes. In 2018, when we visited Thailand, most bars and clubs closed early. So basically at 11 every day, it was time to go home and get some rest for the next day. Right, Hugo? Right? So we found a place that accepted to sell us some headache, hardcore liquor illegally. And that was not the only illegal thing. Yeah, look at Hugo's haircut. He could be put and should be put in jail for that. Fortunately, we found Don and his clippers. Hugo got his haircut, I got a beard trim, and we were looking fresh and ready to hit the courts. The food courts. We were about a couple of weeks in and figured it was time for us to increase the level of spiciness in our dishes, passing from a Thai not too spicy to a Thai medium spicy. And guess what? We weren't ready. It was a big mistake. Oh yeah. Our time in Chiang Mai flew by in the blink of an eye, and looking back at it, I wished we stayed longer. But we wanted to go and visit one of those wonderful islands we've heard so much about.